how was your parents to you when growing up? Were they, did they discipline you the same you're disciplining your kids, the same way?
No, 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 no. They disciplined me the hard way.
Okay.
The hard way. Me, I'm a positive reinforcer with my kids. When they do something good, I tell them. I praise them. I reward them. When they do something bad, I tell them that what they did was bad, but I never punish them physically. But when I was growing up, old school, my parents were such negative reinforcers. I love my parents. Don't get me wrong. I love
my
dad. I love my mom. When I do something good, they're quiet. But when I do something bad, I get it. I really get it, no? And my dad was also, he's a very loving man, but he's not a physical guy. I learned to hug my dad later on in life. I was in my 30s already when I started hugging my dad and my mom, because they're not comfortable with that. They're old school, eh? Old school. And then my family also, were not very expressive verbally. We don't say, I love you to each other, no? But right now, because I grew up in that setting, I'm over-expressive naman with my kids now. With my kids, I tell them, I love you 20 times a day. They're so nakukulitan already. And they tell me, Pops, how am I supposed to answer what?
Yeah.
Am I supposed to say I love you all the time also?
What was your turning point? Why did you become like this? Is it because you got sick?
Well, that is another turning point. But with my parents, I became very expressive with them. I attended a seminar. It's called PSI. This was back in the 90s, mid-90s. And then an exercise was given to us. And the exercise was, you now have 1 minute left in your life. What are you going to do? And then, you know, I didn't even think of money. I didn't think of possessions. I didn't think of my ambition. All I thought of, I wasn't married then, were my parents. I thought of my mom and my dad. Lahat ng atraso ko with my mom and my dad. Everything I wanted to say to my mom and my dad. I wanted to say everything in that 1 minute. So the next step after that exercise, whatever you visualized in that 1 minute that we gave you, do it now. We were given 3 hours. So the first thing I did was go to my parents' house. My mom was sleeping. And then I told her, Mom, something I want to tell you. Oh, what? She was half asleep. I couldn't say it.
Nahiya ka rin.
Nahiya ako. Oh. It's not my nature. It's not the nature of the family. I said, Mom, I love you. I just want to say that I love you. My mom was in shock. And then we were crying. My mom started crying. And then she said, Kim, you know, of all my kids, you're my favorite.
Ilan kayo?
We're 6 in the family. Uh-huh. So I hugged my mom. And then that was the beginning of it. I tell my dad I love him. But he reacts differently because he's built a different way. But see, mom now has become very expressive also. I love you, mom. I love you, Kim. My dad also. Love you, dad. Okay. I love you. I want to hug my dad. Then he'll just tap me on the shoulder. Okay, dad. Okay, son. Okay. Ganun lang.
What's one thing you miss most about your mom?
I miss her cooking. Ay, nako. My mom is designed to make you fat. The way she cooks food. Every time I would eat in their house, that would be at least once a week, I put on at least 2 pounds. The way she cooks her nilaga, kare-kare, bakalaw. My mom is designed to make you fat. And she loves food. My dad also, huh? My dad's 80 years old, but he eats steak like a 19-year-old with the fat. And then he smokes a good long cigar after.
Wow.
But he's 80. Yeah,
it's time to enjoy.
He can do anything he wants to do. Yeah. And he's been doing it all his life anyway. And he hates doctors. My dad hates doctors.
Really?
Because according to my dad, whenever he goes to a doctor, the doctor will just say that he's something wrong with him. Might as well not go na lang pa. Parang you pay the doctor to tell the doctor, for the doctor to tell you that there's something wrong with you.
Yeah. You know, Kuya Kim, when I got married last year with Sarah, I don't know why, how, but I appreciate my parents. I've always appreciated and loved my parents so much, though. No? But after getting married, I appreciate my mom and my dad so much more.
I know what you're going through, man.
So much more.
Aren't you in tears when it's Christmas time?
Not just Christmas time. like, you know, and just to realize the fact that my parents allowed themselves to let go of me and my sister to get married and to have another life.
Yes. You know, let me share with you, no? My first years of marriage with Feli, I'm so close to my family, eh, to my initial family. My mom and my dad. We're so close that we have meals together. We're adults na. Mm-hmm. We have meals together minimum of once a week, sometimes even more. Christmas time we used to spend together all the time since I was 1 year old. Mm-hmm. Up to the time I got married, every Christmas Eve we'd be together. Mm. I got married na to Feli. My first Christmas being married to Feli. Feli's a very personal. She's not like me that I like people, like to be around.
She's strong
people.
Also.
Super strong, stronger than me. But she's also very. She likes small dinners, just me and her and the kids. She grew up in a small family, one brother lang eh. Mm. That's her idea of intimacy and the closeness during Christmas. So therefore, my Christmas dinner, I was married na, was with Feli and my one kid. And that was it. And in my heart, parang I missed that. I was thinking of the laughter in my parents' house, what all the years that I spent Christmas with them. And that was the first Christmas that I was not with my parents. And I felt sad. But you know what happened, no? Just before midnight, see how understanding our parents are. I hear knocking on my door. It was my dad. Just before Christmas, he visited us. He knew that what I was going through. Eh. Visited me and Feli, spent just a few minutes with us, greeted us Merry Christmas, gave me a hug, and then went back.
Gave you space again.
Yeah. It's amazing how you think your parents don't know.
But they know everything.
They know. They've been through whatever we went through. Eh. But you know, one thing in the Bible that's so clear naman that we have to stick to is to leave and cleave. Leave and cleave. When you get married, you leave your family. You honor them, you still love them, but you got to cut yourself 100% from them, and then you cleave with your wife. You become one flesh with your wife. That is the only way for a marriage to work. Without that, it will be very difficult.
It's easier said than done.
Siyempre sinabi mo. Lalo na with conflict.
Yeah, like for me, leaving and cleaving was very, very important, and we're learning every day. You know, we're always reminding ourselves, leave and cleave. But that doesn't mean you don't love your parents anymore. You,
no,
you still honor
you
them.
Honor you them. Them. And you find a way to still get in touch with them.
Yeah.
You talk to them, you bond with them still, but you leave them.
So leaving and cleaving for us, spouses, it feels this certain way. It's difficult. How much more for the parents? Can you imagine your daughter leaving and cleaving from you?
Ay nako, my kid, I told you the story kanina. My kid na Jose started studying in Boston. Mm. He's in Tufts University now in Boston. Eh. Just a few months leading to that day that he was going to leave me was already painful. I was hurting na eh. The day he left me, I cried like a baby for 3 days.
Did you show your son?
No. But I showed my daughter. My daughter knows. And my daughter eventually told my son. It was that painful.
Why? Then, how did this feel? Like, what was the emotion
like,
going?
Like he was a baby. He was my baby. You know, I would carry him every single day. He was my possession. Then all of a sudden, he's totally independent and he's a man. Actually, I wanted to be emotional with him. Eh. The night before he was going to leave and he was packing, I entered this room and I wanted to just, you know, converse with him and give him my huling bilin, no? But he was so busy packing, he said, "Pops, can you leave me?
How did that
see,
feel?
Can't you see that I'm packing?" I was hurt. I was hurt, but I realized that he is his own man and I have to give him space. I can't be asserting myself all the time on an 18-year-old young man.
Did you think in that moment he knew what you were feeling? No, I hurt my dad.
Probably
he was just going through life.
He's going through life. When I was, then what I do naman kasi is I compare him to me when I was 18. Mm. And I realize what a good son I have. Mm. Because when I was 18, I was bad.
What's bad?